The United Nations General Assembly overwhelmingly backs a Palestinian bid to become a full UN member. In a survey, 143 of the 193 member body voted in support of Palestine's bid, which would effectively recognize it as a state. The General Assembly now recommends that the Security Council reconsider the matter favorably. Palestine's bid failed to pass the Security Council after the U.S. vetoed the resolution. But Hungary, which voted against the General Assembly resolution, had this to say.
We believe that at present, the current resolution is not conducive to easing the situation and finding a peaceful solution to the conflict in the Middle East. In fact, it may directly contribute to its escalation. While debating the present resolution, the aforementioned serious facts cannot be disregarded, as they are contrary to the spirit of the United Nations.
The U.S. State Department says Israel may have violated international law in its military operations in Gaza. The agency issued that strong criticism in a report submitted to the U.S. Congress Friday. It explains the weapons supplied by the U.S. might have been used in ways inconsistent with Israel's obligations. While the report was a clear rebuke of some Israeli operations in Gaza, it fell short of ordering a full stop to America's flow of weapons and bombs to its key ally. For a former State Department official, the report is self-contradictory.
I think that in some ways the administration and the State Department are trying to have their cake and eat it too. They're trying to be seen to be levying criticism while steering clear of the legal determinations that would bind their hands and potentially lead to restrictions on arms transfers in particular.
Israel launched a military campaign in Gaza to destroy Hamas in response to the military group's October 7 attack, which killed 1,200 people. Nearly 35,000 have been killed in Gaza since then. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky vows to defend Kharkiv after Russian troops launched a ground attack in the area Friday. Ukraine's defense ministry says reserve units were sent to the Kharkiv border as Russian forces, backed with armored vehicles, attempt to breach Kyiv's defense lines. The attack in the northeastern city, which is Kyiv's second largest city and home to 1.3 million people, opens a new front in a war that has long been waged in the east and south. It comes after the White House announced a fresh $400 million military aid package for Kyiv.
We are adding our strength to the Kharkiv directions, along our state border and along the entire front line. We will consistently destroy the occupier in such a way as to thwart any Russian offensive intentions. It is important that our partners support our soldiers and Ukrainian resilience with timely supplies. The package that really helps is the weaponry brought to Ukraine, not just the announcement of a package.
And 50 people in northern Afghanistan are killed in flooding triggered by heavy rains. The country's interior ministry said the death toll may rise. The disaster also left 100 more people injured. The government has deployed search and rescue teams to affected areas. Now, Brits are left in awe as northern lights dazzle the night sky across the UK. Videos showed pink and green hues glowing over residential areas in Britain. Also known as aurora borealis, these lights appear brightly, looking like swirling curtains of lights, with colors ranging from green to pink and scarlet. The rare light show appeared after one of the strongest geomagnetic storms hit Earth. Scientists also expect the northern lights to appear in some parts of the U.S.